It's actually the first time I'm talking about that in this channel, since it's a little bit more advanced, so... So I wanted to come back to this trading day because it was a very interesting day, mainly because of a SMT divergence. So I don't talk too much about that in the channel, but I saw the SMT divergence happening on US 100. So let's study it so we can learn from that. So I'm the 15 minute, not much, except that we've been going down since midnight. On the 5 minute, I can see here quickly a fair value gap right there. Well, let's just go to the 1 minute. So starting at 9 a.m., we can see that the 2 days low was around 8:30. Alright, so let's stop here. So you can see here that at 9:30 we came up, then we had this fair value gap right there, but this was not a trade since we didn't break a low, okay? Then what happened next? We came back, we took out those lows, but I would not consider those very important. Then we had this displacement right there with a displacement of more than 600, as you can see. However, since this was not a very significant takeout, let's check, however, on US 500 what happened. On US 500, you can see here that we took out the 2 days low, which were around 8:30, and then we had this displacement right there. So this is a great example of SMT divergence. US 500 in this case was a little bit weaker than US 100. US 100, you can see here, since it didn't do a low and went directly up, without taking out 2 days low, it would be better to buy US 100 since it's stronger. It's more bullish than US 500. However, the only thing is that we filled up this fair value gap before 9:55. We filled up at 9:54 and I cannot take this one. But let's see if we have a second leg. So we did have a second leg. Let's check the displacement. 700. So I would be allowed to take this one right there. But you can try different things for yourself. And if you don't want the rule of 9:55, you just want to take every trade or whatever, you're very open to do it. You would have been allowed to take this one. However, you can see here that if you would have put your order right there, you would need a large stop loss to not be taking out around here. You could use maybe those, I think those are some of the blocks, I'm not too sure about that. But you could put your order right there. But for me personally, if I just miss the first one, I maybe check for the second leg. And then let's check if we can get a good risk to reward ratio on this one. So once again, because we had liquidity taking out on US 500 and we had the SMT divergence that ICT introduced, we're taking US 100 since it's stronger. We had the break of the highs, we have the fair value gap, we put the stop loss, the take profit. Let's check. This level is giving 2.57, this level right there. So let's go with this one. In less than 5 minutes. So that's awesome. And since we're still before 11, I'm still allowed to take a trade. So after taking out those levels, this one, and I guess this one too, we start going down. Let's check the displacement, 400. So this is not enough, but you can see here a nice fair value gap with the break of this low right there. But I don't take those. Let's check the second leg. Maybe if we have a 600, we might take it. Okay, so we came to the fair value gap. However, displacement is 450. But look at the precision with this order block. I think this is an order block. We came back to it, fair value gap, then we went down. But since it's not part of my trading plan, I don't mind. I had a good trade today for 2.6, so I don't really mind. Now on this one, we do have 600. However, I'm not too sure about this one because it's a third leg. I don't like taking those third legs since it's too far. So I'm not going to take this one either. But come on, look at this precision once again. So you need to work on your own trading plan, see what works for you, what doesn't work for you, and you choose to take what you want. If someone was to trade something that lower than 600 or their own trading plans, he could have taken this one right there. He could have taken this one. And even this one up again. 250. And look at the precision of all of that. And there you go. For all of them take profit. So if we're to take every single fair value gap trade that we saw during this day, we would have this one that we took following my trading plan, which gave it 2.6. This one for 4.74, this one for 3.68, and this one for 3%. However, we should not expect to get those results every single time. So I know I have my trading plan. I know that sometimes I do miss those kind of trades, this one and this one, even this one because it was a third leg, and I'm okay with that. You don't need 12%, or I don't even know how much it adds up to, maybe 15%. You don't need all of those 15%. What if you can just get a 3%? This is just one day of trading and you would be done for the week. Even though we saw all of those opportunities, all you need to do as a trader is just take one of them. But you still don't know all the differences between S&P 500 and Nasdaq. So you can check out this video where I go over another difference between the two.